Hi, welcome to the series of video lectures on pulse and digital circuit subject. So we are discussing chapter 1. The name of the chapter is linear wave shaping. So in this chapter we will see today attenuator, what is attenuator and what is compensated attenuator, what is the condition for compensated attenuator. So first of all, the attenuator definition is very simple. So it is a resistor divider network. It is a resistor divider network which reduces amplitude of input signal without distorting its shape. So this is the definition of attenuator. That means attenuator is a resistor divider network which reduces the amplitude of the input signal. Remember that it reduces the amplitude of the input signal to the required level without distorting its shape. So that is the simple definition of attenuator. Let us consider one attenuator. For example, say it is a resistor divider network. For example, say it consists of only two resistors. So resistor R1 and R2. Resistor R1 and R2. So this simple circuit is called as a resistive attenuator. So to which we apply a voltage of V of T, which is whose amplitude is to be reduced. The current through this loop is say I of T. The output voltage we take across V0T, which is the reduced amplitude of VI of T, while keeping the output waveform shape same as that of input wave shape. So let us, from this, applying Kirchhoff voltage law to the loop. So what is from the circuit VI of T? So VI of T is equal to I of T into R1 plus R2. Simple formula. So what is VI of T from this loop? The VI of T from this loop is I of T into R1 plus R2. So what is V0 of T? So V0 of T is nothing but as I of T into R2. So we need output voltage by input voltage. So that is V0 of T by VI of T. So that is equal to I of T gets cancels out. R2 by R1 plus R2. So from which the output voltage V0 of T is equal to R2 by R1 plus R2 into input voltage VI of T. So this is the output voltage formula. For example, for this circuits, let us say, for example, what is our circuit? For example, if you give, say, step input voltage to the given circuit, say this is our output voltage V0 of T versus T. So this is zero line. So let us draw the input line. For example, if you give a step input voltage to this circuit, resistor divider circuit of amplitude V, so you can clearly see that, for example, R2 by R1 is equal to say A into VI of T, where A is equal to R2 by R1 plus R2. So the V0 of T will become, so A into, what is input voltage amplitude? Input voltage amplitude is V. So that means the input voltage is reduced, is multiplied by a factor of A. So that is the output voltage. So therefore, you can see that how to draw this output voltage. So this is the input voltage. The output voltage of the attenuator is, so this line, its amplitude is V, A into V. So this black line is your input line, input, and the blue line is your output. You can clearly see that the amplitude of the signal is get reduced. For example, let us say, let us consider a simple divider network. For example, let us say, so this is 1 kilo ohm, in order to understand. For example, if you give a 4 volt step input, for example, say 4 volt step input to this circuit, this resistor divider circuit. You can clearly see that by using this formula. By using this formula, R2 by R1 plus R2, 1 by 1 plus 2 into 4. That means it will, the output will become 2 volts. So this is V0 of T versus T. So you can see that the amplitude of 4 volts is reduced to 2 volts because of this resistor divider arrangement. So this is your input voltage. So for example, if you give a sinusoidal voltage to this, for example, it's the same circuit. For example, if you give a sinusoidal voltage something like this of 4 volts and minus 4 volts, the output will come here. So same voltage divider formula, it will come 2 volts and minus 2 volts. You can clearly see that the shape of the output is same faithful reproduction of the input, except that the output amplitude is reduced. So that is the purpose of this resistor attenuator, which reduces the amplitude of the input signal by preserving its shape or without disturbing its shape. So this is what about the basics of attenuator. Now in practical circuits, let us say in practical circuits there is always a stray capacitance associated with R2. So you can clearly see that, for example, what is our divider network? So this is your resistor divider network, simple circuit, R2. So this is your input and this is your output. Say this is your input and this is your output. So there is always, because this output may be connected to some other circuit, the other circuit may introduce certain stray capacitance. So therefore, in practical circuits, so there is always a capacitance C2 we have to consider. This C2 is because of stray capacitance of the circuit that is connected to this output. What is stray capacitance? Stray capacitance is the capacitance due to the circuit which is connected to this output. So therefore, this is the capacitor we have to include in practical circuits. So basically, it consists of R1, R2, but in practical circuits, we have to consider a stray capacitance C2. So the effect of this value C2 is to distort the input wave shape. So therefore, without this capacitor, the output waveform will be same as that of input waveform with reduced amplitude. But because of this capacitor, what will happen is that the output waveform will tend to distort. So that is what we will write, the effect of C2 is to distort, the effect of C2 is to distort input wave form. The effect of the C2 is to distort the input waveform. So in order to neutralize this effect of C2, in order to neutralize the effect of C2, we place a capacitor. For example, this is our resistor divider network. This is the resistor divider network, say R1, R2. So I said earlier, we have to consider in practical circuit a stray capacitance C2 across R2. This is because of the input circuit, that circuitry that is connected to this output. So therefore, the effect of C2 is to distort the input waveform. So therefore, in order to neutralize this effect of this C2, we connect a capacitor C1 across R1. So this C1 neutralizes the effect of C2. So this attenuator is called as compensated attenuator. The name of this attenuator is compensated attenuator, very very important word, compensated attenuator. So therefore C2 is fixed, you cannot change C2. So what value of C1 is taken such that the output wave shape is preserved? So the condition for compensated attenuation is simple formula R1C1 is equal to R2C2. So therefore that is what we write, the condition for compensated attenuator, the condition for compensated attenuator is, so simple formula R1C1 is equal to R2C2. So this is the formula for compensated attenuator. So let us derive this formula R1C1 is equal to R2C2. Let us do this proof. So at first let us, number one, at t is equal to 0 plus, say at the time t is equal to 0 plus, the capacitors act as short circuit. So due to that the resistors will go out of the circuit, so you can see that in this circuit, see, this is your compensated attenuator. So this is the input to the compensated attenuator, so this is the output of the compensated attenuator. At t is equal to 0 plus in this circuit, so as you know, the capacitors acts as short circuits, so therefore these resistors will go out of the picture. So therefore the circuit consisting of a t is equal to 0 plus, only C1 and C2, that is what we write here. So therefore at t is equal to 0 plus, the equivalent circuit is say C1 and C2, because the resistors will go out of the circuit. So this is C1, this is C2, so this is the VI of 0 plus, that is the voltage at 0 plus time. So this is the output voltage V0 at a 0 plus time. So now let us call the charge, because the capacitors are in series, the charge in series capacitors is always Q and Q. Let us call the voltage across this capacitor, say V1, the voltage across this capacitor is say V2. So therefore, what is by VI of 0 plus is equal to voltage across capacitor plus voltage across second capacitor C2. So as you know this formula, Q is equal to CV. So what is V1? Q by C1, because the same charge exists, Q by C1, plus what is V2? Q by C2. So if you take Q as common, you can get C1 plus C2 by C1 plus C1 C2. So this is the first one we have to write. Similarly, V0 of 0 plus, that is the output voltage at t is equal to 0 plus time. So what is the output voltage? V2. So but what is V2? Q by C2. Now, the initial attenuation, remember this word, initial attenuation. So that is represented as the output at 0 plus time, that is at t is equal to 0 plus time, divided by input at 0 plus time. So you divide, for example, say this is equation A, say this is equation B. If you divide B by A, you can get that. So QQ gets cancels out. So therefore, it will come out as C1 by C1 plus C2. You can clearly see that Q by C2 into VI of 0 plus you substitute. So Q into C1, so Q into C1 C2 by C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. So you can clearly check that C2 C2 gets cancels out, QQ gets cancels out. It will come out as C1 by C1 plus C2. So this is the initial attenuation. Remember that this is the initial attenuation. Now, so case 2, we'll take case 2. At t is equal to infinity time, that is under steady state condition, under steady state condition, the capacitors act as open circuit. The capacitor acts as open circuit. So that means you can clearly see that this is your compensated attenuator. At t is equal to infinity, so these capacitors will act as open circuit. So therefore, only resistors will remain in the circuit. That is the equivalent circuit it will draw. So therefore, at t is equal to infinity, so we draw the circuit because the capacitors acts as open circuit. What is our attenuator? Attenuator consisting of only resistors R1 and R2. So this is at what time? This is at a time Vi of infinity. So this is V0 of infinity. So directly, because it is resistor divided network, so the final attenuation, which is nothing but as the output at infinity by input at infinity. So that is simply, you can easily get out that R2 by R1 plus R2. So that is what Vi of infinity is equal to I into R1 plus R2. So V0 of infinity is equal to I into R2. Ii gets cancelled out. What is the simple formula? R2 by R1 plus R2. So let us call this equation as Roman 1. So let us call this equation as Roman 2. So for perfect compensation, the initial attenuation, what is the amount of attenuation at initial time, must be same as the attenuation at infinity time. So therefore, for compensated attenuator, the initial attenuation must be is equal to final attenuation. So that is what we will write. For compensation to be complete, for perfect compensation, or we can write for perfect compensation, the initial attenuation is equal to final attenuation. So if these two are equal, then attenuation is complete. It will be lead to perfect attenuation. What is the initial attenuation we got from normal letter 1? C1 by C1 plus C2. What is the final attenuation we got? R2 by R1 plus R2. If you cross multiply this, R1 C1 plus R2 C1 is equal to R2 C1 plus R2 C2. So you can cancel out this R2 C1 and R2 C1. You can get R1 C1 is equal to R2 C2. So this is the condition for perfect compensated attenuator. Because I said earlier, C2 is fixed. C2 is the state capacitance which you cannot change. So therefore, we have to place the capacitor C1. So therefore, from which the capacitor C1 is equal to, what is the formula? R2 C2 by R1, which we call it as Cp. So this is the value of capacitance we have to put in the circuit in order to remove the effect of C2, in order to achieve perfect compensation. Now, so let us consider case 1. For example, what is our attenuator? So this is your attenuator. This is a simple circuit R1, R2. Simple circuit R1, R2. As I said earlier, so this capacitance you cannot change, stay capacitance, because of the input circuitry that is connected to this circuit, C2. So in order to neutralize this effect of C2, what we do? So we place a capacitor C1 across this. So C1 is calculated by using this formula. So suppose case 1, if you get C1 is equal to Cp, so that means by using this formula, what we get C1, if you place the same value of C1 here, so then it is called perfect compensation. So that means the output will not distort. Case 2. Suppose if we put a value of C1 that is greater than Cp, if you keep a capacitor C1 which is greater than the value which we get from this formula, so therefore if you, then it is called overcompensation. Remember these words, overcompensation. While solving the problems we use these terms, overcompensation, undercompensation, perfect compensation. If you keep C1 greater than Cp, then it is called as overcompensation. In that case, so how to draw the waveform, let us see. So let us see this waveform. So this is the output waveform. Remember, this is the output waveform. This is T. This is T. So this is your input line. For example, let us say it is a step input voltage. So V, step input voltage V. So this is your input. Ideally, in ideal condition, so the output has to come like this because it only reduces the amplitude. Ideally, the output voltage should have to come like this. So this is AV, AV. But because of overcompensation, this is in case, for example, this is in case of perfect compensation. Let us say this is in case of perfect compensation. For example, if you do overcompensation, so the output will come something like this. The output will start then some value, at some value say it exponentially decreases and finally settle down to this value. So this amplitude, is called as initial attenuation. So that is V0 of 0 plus. This amplitude is called as the initial attenuation. So this amplitude is called as output at time infinity. So this is the diagram of overcompensation. What is this figure? This figure is overcompensation diagram. This is compensation diagram. So in this way you have to draw overcompensation diagram. Remember that. Ideally, for perfect compensation, the output has to come like this. Because of overcompensation, that is C1 is greater than Cp, the output starts at some initial or finally settle down to this amplitude. So now last case we will take case 3. So suppose if you take a value of C1 which is less than the value Cp which is actually required, so then it is called under compensation. So let us draw this diagram in the same manner. For example, say, our resistor divider network, we have given a step input. So this is the output V0 of T versus T. So to this circuit, what is our input? Our input is a step voltage of amplitude V. In case of perfect compensation, how the output has to come? The output has to come something like this with reduced amplitude, say, A into V. Because of undercompensation, remember that because of undercompensation, initially the output starts at this point, and increases exponentially and finally settle down to this value. So this this is called as undercompensation. The amplitude here, you can simply represent it as V0 of 0 plus. At this time, this is the amplitude. By the time it reaches to infinity, the output settled down to this value. So this is called as, this is undercompensated waveform. This red one is your in case of perfect compensation. So this one is your input waveform VA of T. So this figure is called as, this figure is for the output waveform which will come for undercompensation, for, remember that, for step input voltage. So this is what you have to write. About the attenuator. Attenuator is a resistor divider network which reduces the amplitude of the input signal without distorting its shape. So, but in practical circuits, there is always some stray capacitance. In order to neutralize this capacitor, we place a capacitor C1. So this is the condition for to select the capacitor. So that is R1 C1 is equal to R2 C2. Why this formula has come is derived here. Initial attenuation is equal to final attenuation. So this is the formula we have, according to which we have to take C1. Suppose if you take C1 is equal to, that means CP, this value is called a CP. For example, if you take the same value, then it is called a perfect compensation, then the output wave shape will remain undistorted. For example, if you take a capacitor greater than CP, it is called as overcompensation. The diagram of overcompensation for step input will be like this. So if you take a value of capacitor which is less than CP, so it is called as undercompensation. In case of undercompensation, for step input, the response of attenuator will be something like this. So this is what you have to write in the examination to get complete marks for this article. Thank you.